what we are looking towards is that there really has to be a locally pushed effort in partnership with the Census Bureau to make sure that all of our citizens, all of our communities are counted. Because we were ahead of the curve this last year, we have already cleaned up and identified nearly 85,000 new addresses in the city of Atlanta.
If you have paid attention to anything that's happening in our state capitol right now, you know that we need to make sure that all Atlantans are counted in the upcoming census.
Our work depends on all residents being counted so that we can effectively fulfill our mission. If we don't get an accurate account, less government money comes, more pressure is put on nonprofits that really is not going to be able to be sustained over a long period of time. So we fully support the city's goal of getting 80%, I say 100% participation, and we'll do everything we can to help make that happen.
So census is about two things, and I'm gonna need your help to repeat after me. The two things, power and money. What is it? I can't hear you. Power and money. What is it? That's right, and it is about who controls the power and money that comes to our community. Is the city of Atlanta interested in having an extra $100 million? What can we do with an extra $100 million? We can do a lot with an extra $100 million.
We are going to work every day for the next 365 days to make sure that the youth and minorities of our city do not go undercounted again. With over 129,000 students living in the city of Atlanta, it is critical that we all get counted. If you go to school in the city of Atlanta and you live on campus, make sure to be counted as part of the city of Atlanta.
The faith community also read that it takes more than faith to make things happen. It takes work as well. And in this case, that work is to be counted in the upcoming census.